Hello and welcome everyone, Tiberius here, and today's video is an edited down live stream where I solved TimeKORP from the HackTheBox Cyber Apocalypse CTF 2024. The challenge was rated as very easy, and that was a pretty accurate rating, especially since we got the source code. As always, please consider giving this video a like, subscribing to the channel, and leaving a comment with your thoughts. Now, let's get solving. All right, TimeKORP had actual code. This is the first code review. So as I tell everyone when doing code review in these challenges, always look at the Docker file, because it'll give you a good idea of what's going on. Specifically that we're using PHP, it'll tell you if there's anything odd being configured. In this case, doesn't look like it. We're copying the flag to just slash flag. The build Docker is basic. You can look down the config, but honestly, a lot of this is fine. Nothing really going on. So it's just a challenge we need to look at. This router.php is basic as well. This is also basic. All we know is that we've got a get request to forward slash goes to the time controller and it runs the index function. So there should be a time controller here. All right, and that runs the index function. It gets a format from the URL and it passes it into the new time model. And it uses a template to pass the get time into the template. So if we look at the models, and we go to time model, we can see that when it's constructed, so when we do this, right, this is the constructor here, the format is placed into this internal command variable in this structure. And then when we run get time, which is what we do here, when it's passing it to the template, it runs exec. Lovely. So exec in PHP specifically runs the command in a shell. So actually, if we load this web app, we can select what's the date and it'll tell us, okay, here's the format. So let's go here. Okay, and we could just do a search for its and then do auto scroll. All right, so we send a format and it prints the date in the format. So we know from our code review that this is the time command. And so what's going to happen, it's always good to just see how our variable gets placed into it. So what we can do is we can take out the double quotes at either end. We can take out this semicolon because it's part of it. And then we know that basically anything with double quotes like that, we can replace with our actual command here. So in this case, all right, this is what's run. All right, this is how this, and we can control anything in between here. And so this was honestly quite a simple challenge because we could literally just do a single quote, right? A semicolon, and then we could do anything we wanted. We could do a sleep five, right? A semicolon and comment out the rest of the line. So if we copy all of this, paste it in there and URL encode it, then we sleep for 5 seconds. So you can't see, my head is kind of covering the thing here, but you can see it slept for 5,000 milliseconds. So the solution is very easy, honestly. Where's the flag? If you go to a Docker file, flag is copied to slash flag. Okay, so what we need to do is replace our sleep five with just a cat flag, apply the change, replay, there's the flag. Does Burp scanner detect this kind of stuff? It should do it. Yeah, it should. We can actually check, because I've got Burp Pro here, so if we send this to intruder, and honestly, we probably want to do a configuration. I'm not sure. So this is the thing. It might. If it doesn't, then what we'll find it is the extensions to the command injection. We can see though. So let's do. Oh, I did find it, yeah. Oh, it actually found it by, yeah, echoed it out, I think, somehow, yeah. So it does find it. It's very good. But again, there's a lot of extensions. The backslash powered scanner is really good. for finding stuff like that. Command injection attacker is very good for finding stuff like that. Even though Burp Scanner is pretty good at finding base cases, the fact that it's extensible, and if you enable a lot of these extensions, like backslash powered scanner would generally find this as well. I honestly recommend, if you struggle with this one, do the code review, copy out the actual command that's being run, replace the, so you don't need this, right? Because ultimately this is what's being executed. So whatever string you put as the format here, this is the command that's being executed. And so once you realize that this is being executed, you can realize, oh, well, I can just escape out of this string here. I can put a semicolon. I can comment out. I don't actually need to comment out. I could have done, like, you could do something like, so let's see, if you do a semicolon and then just do an echo and then like test, there's test, right? Because all we're doing here is we're doing echo test. Now we have two commands. We have the date, right? And then we have an echo test. And you know, this is just a redirection. This is nothing. So you could do that, but honestly, remember that there is a hash symbol. So you have to encode that hash symbol because you can't put that symbol in the URL generally. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed the video, please consider giving it a like, subscribing to the channel, and of course, leaving a comment to let me know what you thought. See you next time.